Hello everyone, this is Shikha, your English teacher. Now we are starting our first chapter of the book, Moments. The name of the chapter is The Lost Child, written by Mulk Raj Anand. A little introduction of the chapter. A child goes to a fair with his parents. He is happy and excited and wants the sweets and toys displayed there. But his parents don't buy them for him. Why then does he refuse when someone else offers them to him? So this story is about a child who visits a fair and is very excited after seeing so many things first time in his life, and he wants to grab them all. But what exactly happened that he started refusing all the things? So we are going to see in this story. Find some new words from the text that will help you to explain the chapter. Now here we start a chapter. It was the festival of spring. Now spring is a season when all the flowers bloom. Okay, everywhere you can see the fresh flowers in the garden, in the field. So this was the festival of spring. From the wintry shades of narrow lanes and alleys emerged a gaily clad humanity. Now alleys is called narrow way. Lanes means road or street. Emerged is called to come out. Gaily is called happily. Clad means to clothed. Okay. Humanity is called mankind. So it was the end of the winter. After the winter, which season comes? Spring. So this is the spring season when all the flowers were blooming everywhere, and the street, the roads, the narrow lanes, all has come out with a happy clothing of a humankind. Means everywhere you can see a type of happiness, a freshness, a clearness. Some walked, some rode on horses, others sat being carried in the bamboo and bulk carts. Now, so many peoples in the spring season came out from their home to celebrate the spring, the festival of spring. Now, they are wearing so many colorful clothes, so many are walking on the road, some of the persons are riding horses, some were set behind of those carts, and some were taking the bamboo. Bamboo is a type of tree, and bulk carts is a type of cart which is driven by the bull. Okay, so that is called bull cart. So some people were sitting on the bull cart. One little boy ran between his father's leg. Now there is so many people among those persons. There is a one little boy who just came out happily between his father's leg, brimming over with life and laughter. Now brimming over, when somebody is so happy that is coming out, means overshowed the joy. You can say the full of liquid that is over flowing over. When we fill the water in the glass, then it comes out with the overflow. Same at brimming over, here comes with the overflowing happiness. So the child was so happy to celebrate the festival of spring that he was being so overjoyed with life and laughter. Here in the picture you can see the child is so happy. He cannot just attach with this happiness. So his happiness is just coming out with power. "Come, child, come," called his parents as he lagged behind. Now that boy who was going with his parents is calling him to come to them. Why? Because that boy was left behind, fascinated by the toys in the shops that lined the way. Now where the boy was left behind? He was out in a fair, in an exhibition with his parents. So in that fair, so many stalls, so many shops of the toys were there in a line. And after seeing those toys, the child was fascinated too. Fascinated means attracted to those toys. So he was looking back again and again. That's why his parents were calling him. He hurried towards his parents, his feet obedient to their call. Hurried is called quickly. Now when his parents were calling him, he quickly went to them, and his feet obedient. Obedient is called to obey. Okay, the parents were saying something and the child was following, and as his feet were going towards his parents. His eyes is still lingering on the receding toys. Now, lingering is called lasting for a long time. Means when you see a thing for a long time, and a receding is called left behind as he walked. Means as he walking towards his parents, the toy shops were left behind, but still he was so attracted to the toys that he was going ahead but looking behind. As he came to where they had stopped to wait for him. Now his parents waited and stopped for him to let the child come to him. Then he could not suppress the desire of his heart, even though he well knew the old cold stare of the refusal in their eyes. Now suppress is called to put to an end, to finish. Okay, desire means a choice. Okay, refusal is called deny. Okay, and cold stare. Cold here means the without any emotion. Very cruel. Okay, stare means the parents were looking him with a very cruel, without feeling of emotions. This was the look of the parents for the child, because the child knows very well that his parent is not going to buy anything for him, and he can see this refusal. Refusal, again I say, means they will deny. No, you are not going to buy anything, and the child can see this refusal in the eyes of his parents. I want that toy, he pleaded. Pleaded is called requested, but even then the boy made a request that he wants a toy. His father looked at him red-eyed in his familiar tyrant way. Now his father was getting very angry, and he looked at the boy with his red eyes. When we get angry, then eyes became red. So his father was looking at him with the red eyes. His mother, melted by the free spirit of the days, was tender and giving him her finger to hold. But the mother, the lady, is having a soft heart. That's why he melted. Melted is called means a tender in a loving way. Okay, free spirit, in a tender and loving spirit, because the day was so tender. Tender is called delicate and beautiful. The day was very beautiful because they all have come out to celebrate the festival of spring. So with this tenderness, with this softness, the mother gave her finger to that child to hold and said, "Look, child, what is before you?" Now the mother wants to divert the mind of the child, because his father was shouting on him. And whether the boy would not feel a type of fear, that's why the mother is becoming so loving towards that child and holding his finger, and she was saying, "See what is there, come here." Look in this picture that how the child is pointing towards balloon, rides, sweets and flowers, but his parents are forcing him to go ahead. So this was the real situation during exhibition time. It was a flowering mustard field. Now what his mother was showing to him, there was a huge mustard field blooming with the yellow color flower, pale like melting gold as it swept across miles and miles of even length. So like gold is too of yellow color, so it was looking like somebody has melted the gold and spread all over the field. That's why the field was looking blooming with yellow color flower and green, and that was swept across, is called a spread, miles and miles. The field was so big that that is spreaded till far away, very long. A group of the dragonflies were bustling around on their gaudy purple wings. Now, dragonfly is a type of insect, and bustling is called full of energy. Gaudy means extremely bright. There was a group of the dragonflies, the insect, who were full of energy, and they were hovering around the yellow colors mustard field in their extremely bright purple color wings. Intercepting the flight of a lone black bee or a butterfly in search of sweetness from the flowers. Now, besides dragonfly, there were more insects, like honeybee was there, a butterfly was there, but they are not so many in number. So honeybee and butterfly wants to fly, but the group of the dragonfly intercepting is called making hurdle or stopping. means the group of those dragonfly was stopping the way of honeybee and butterfly. So honeybee and butterfly was not able to fly in the sky than in search of sweetness from the flower. Now dragonfly, honeybee, butterfly, they all were hovering there in the field. Why? Because they want to take the sweetness of the mustard flowers. You must have seen sitting these insects like dragonfly, butterfly, some of the insects sitting on the flower. Why they sit over the flower? Because they want to take the sweetness of that flower. That's why you can find so many insects in the field. The child followed them in the air with the gaze. Gaze is called when you are looking something continuously. The child was so fascinated, so attracted towards these beautiful, colorful insects that he was looking continuously and tried to follow these insects till one of them would still its wings and rest, and he would try to catch it. He was just waiting that one of the insect from them with still is called without any movement, means still his wing stopped flying its wing and he came to this insect and catch it, but it would go fluttering, flapping up into the air. But the boy was not able to catch any of the insect because the insect was continuously fluttering and flapping, means they were moving their wings in the air. When he had almost caught it in his hand, means whenever the boy just want to try to catch any of the insect, and that moment, that insect flew away. Then his mother gave a cautionary call. Now, cautionary means a very warning, means a type of seriousness is there in the call. So his mother gave a cautionary call, a serious or a warning call. Come, child, come on the footpath. Now, footpath is the place to walk for the pedestrian, and on the road the vehicles will go. That's why his mother was saying, come on the footpath, it's time to move on. He ran towards his parents gaily and walked abreast of them for a while. Now, gaily is called happily, and walk abreast means going side by side. So when his mother called, he went to his parents happily and he was walking side of his parents. Being, however, soon left behind, attracted by the little insects and worms along the footpath, they were teeming out from their hiding places to enjoy the sunshine. He was walking with his parents, holding their fingers, but still he was very much attracted with so many insect and worms who were hovering around and coming out from their home to enjoy the sunshine. Teaming out is called in a groups, means so many insects were coming out from their home in groups to enjoy the sunshine. So this scene was attracted that boy very much, and he was walking with his parents but looking behind to the insect. Come, child, come, his parents called from a shade of a grove. Now, grove is a group of trees. Many different type of trees were there. So, it's a little shady area. Now, his parents again calling him that, come, child, come in this grove, where they had seated themselves on the edge of a well. Now, in that grove, there is a well also. So, the parents were feeling a little tiredness. That's why they sit on the shade of that grove near a well. He reins towards them. Now, the child who was very much attracted towards the insect, when his parents called him, he went to them. A shower of the young flowers fell upon the child as he entered the grove, and forgetting his parents, he began to gather the raining petals in his hand. Now, as the grove is a shady area covered all over with the trees, there is a type of canopy of the flowers. Canopy is called, you can say, the ceiling, so that the sunshine cannot come directly. So many flowering trees were also there. So as the child entered that area, that grove area, then so many flower petals were showering on him, fell down on him, and he started gathering those flower petals.
But lo, he heard the cooing of the doves and ran towards his parents shouting. But he has seen that dove. Dove is a type of bird similar to the pigeon but white in color. Very beautiful bird. Okay. So he saw a bird, a dove, and he started following that dove. And that dove was cooing. Cooing is a sound made by dove. And the parents shouting, the dove, the dove. And before his parents, he was shouting, the dove means he wants to show that beautiful dove to his parents. The raining petals dropped from his forgotten hands. Now he was busy in collecting the flowering petals that was raining from the grove, from the trees. But after seeing the dove, he started running before the dove, after the dove, and those petals he gathered in his hand that fell down on the land. Come, child, come, they called to the child, who had now gone running in a wild capers round the banyan tree. Now again the parents started calling the child that come here. Caper is called the skipping movement, in a playful movement with the leg up and down, doing like this, running in a joyful manner. So the child was very busy and skipping in the happy manner round about a banyan tree. There was a big banyan tree and he was taking around that tree, and that time his parents called him, and gathering him up, they look the narrow winding footpath which led to the fair through the mustard fields. And now gathering is called after holding the child in their hand with the narrow, means there was a very narrow lane that is called a winding footpath is there. Through the footpath that led is called to go towards, that way that goes towards a fair they want to go, means they have to go now to the fair, to the exhibition. That's why they collect the child and started moving from that place, from the place of the mustard field. As they neared the village, the child could see many other footpaths full of throngs. Now they are coming to the living area, means right now they were in the open area, in the field area outside of the village, but now they are entering village, and the child can see many of the footpaths, many of the ways were there and full of throngs. Throngs is called crowd, okay? Huge crowd, so many person are there, converging to the whirlpool of the fair. Now converging is called gathering or collecting, means many peoples were gathered there and they were in the whirlpool. Whirlpool is called center of the fair, means now they are in the exhibition, in the fair, and that fair was full with the people. And felt at once repelled and fascinated by the confusion of the world he was entering. Now he was very much you can say happy. Repelled is called cannot show his happiness, and attracted also a little type of confusion was also there in his mind, because that word was a very new for him he was entering. A sweetmeat sailor hawked. Now in that fair first he saw a sweet sailor who was selling different type of sweets, and he hawked to me is called to give a loud sound. Okay, gulab jamun, rasgulla, burfi, jalebi at the corner of the entrance, and a crowd pressed round his counter at the foot of an architecture of many colored sweet. Now he was taking a loud voice and screaming out about all the sweets he was having in his shop. They were gulab jamun, rasgulla, burfi, jalebi, and everybody, and that shop was in the corner of the entrance of the fair, and the crowds were the crowd means the all the people were so want of taking those sweets that everybody was pushing over that shop. Okay, but those sweets were looking like architecture of many colors. That architecture means the construction. As you have seen the buildings, some of the buildings are very tall buildings, short buildings, some of the buildings are behind of the road means ahead of the road, on the side, like that means taller and shorter. So in this form, all the sweets, different color sweets, he was arranging in his sweet shop, so that were looking at colorful architecture sweet shop, decorated with the leaves of the silver and gold. So all the sweets were decorated with the silver and gold color foil. The child stared open-eyed and his mouth watered for the burfi that was his favorite sweet. Now the child was looking at those delicious sweets and his the water has come in his mouth. His mouth is filled with the water because he wants his favorite sweet, that was burfi. I want that burfi, he slowly murmured. Means in low voice he told about his wish that he wants burfi. But he half knew as he begged that his plea would not be heeded because his parents would say he was greedy. Heeded is called to pay attention, okay? And greedy is called when somebody wants so many things, and plea is called a request, plea. Okay, so the boy very well knows that his parents is not going to pay attention on his request because his parents is going to see that say that he was a greedy child. So without waiting for an answer, he moved on. So he knows the answer, what his parents is going to say. So without listening to the answer, he moved on ahead. A flower sailor hawked a garland of gulmohar, a garland of gulmohar. Now again he came to a shop where the man was selling different color flowers, and he was making a call, a garland of gulmohar. Garland is a piece, means the gulmohars are beautiful flowers that was pin up in a thread and make a garland that we put in a neck. So he was selling the garland of gulmohar. The child seemed irresistibly drawn. Irresistibly means he was not able to stop himself, and he drew or bent towards that shop. He went towards the basket where the flowers lay heaped and half murmured, "I want that garland." Now he came close to that shop where so many flowers were putting one after another, and in slow voice again he told, "I want that garland." But he well knew his parents would refuse to buy him those flowers because they would say that they were cheap. Now he very well knows the answer, that if he is going to tell to his parents again say that these flowers are very cheap, those are not good, so they are not going to buy for him. So without waiting for an answer, he moved on. Again, this time without paying attention to the answer, any answer, because he knows the answer very well, so he moved on ahead. A man stood holding a pole with yellow, red, green and purple balloons flying from it. Now where the child reached, now child saw a balloon man who was having so many colorful balloon of yellow, red, green and purple colors that were flying in the towards the sky. The child was simply carried away by the rainbow glory of their silken colors, and he was filled with an overwhelming desire to possess them all. Now child carried away is called gone away, fascinated, attracted by. Rainbow glory means different colors. Glory is called the shine. Silken colors is called very soft. After seeing, very soft it were looking. Overwhelming is called extra. Very, you can say, very strong emotion, very strong desire. Possess is called to own them, okay, to have them. So after seeing the so different, soft, bright colors, different rainbow colors of the balloon, the child was so attracted that he was having very strong emotion, strong desire to have those balloons. But he well knew his parents would never buy him the balloons because they would say he was too old to play with such toys. But this time again he knew the answer, that if he going to tell to his parents to buy a balloon for him, his parents is going to tell that now you are a grown up child, now you are not so young that you started playing with a balloon. So he walked on further. Further is called ahead, okay, to go on. Means again he just left over his mind for buying the balloon and he moved on. The snake charmer stood playing a flute to the snake which coiled in itself in a basket. Now, which is the next person? A snake charmer. A person who used to keep a snake in a basket, and they used to play a type of musical instrument, and by listening to that musical instrument, the snake comes out from the basket and entertain everyone. Okay, so there was a snake charmer who was playing the flute, and there was a snake kept in a coiled form. Coiled is called in a circled form, and it was kept in a basket. Its head raised in a graceful band like the neck of a swan. So as the snake charmer started playing the flute, the snake came out from the basket and its neck was looking like a swan in a graceful manner. Graceful is called beautiful manner. The snake was coming out from the basket and its neck was looking like swan. Swan is a type of duck. While the music stole into its invisible ear like the gentle rippling of an invisible waterfall. Now, invisible ear has come means that his snake was not having ears that is not shown outside of the body. Rippling is called again the circling part. When you throw some stone in the water, then you can see the round waves comes in that part. So that rippling has come for the coiling body of the snake. Means that coiling body of the snake was coming out after listening to the music and it was looking like a waterfall. The music was coming like a waterfall into the invisible ear of the snake. The child went towards the snake charmer. The child went to near the snake charmer, but knowing his parents had forbidden him to hear such coarse music as the snake charmer played, he proceeded further. Now, forbidden is called not allowed, and coarse is called unpleasant, and proceeded is called going ahead. So again, the child knew this thing very well that his parents is going to his parents is not allowing him to listen to that unpleasant music, because they are going to say this is very unpleasant music. So that's why after thinking this, the child moved ahead again. There was a roundabout in full swing, man, women and children carried away in the whirling motion. Now there is a roundabout, you can see that this is called a roundabout, a merry-go-round, a ride for the children that was in full swing. Full swing is called in full energy. And all the men, women, children, they all carried away, means they all were lost in the whirling motion. Whirling motion is called circling motion, because that roundabout was moving in a circle. Shrieked and cried with a dizzy laughter. Everybody was shrieking is called in a loud voice. They were speaking and they were crying in a loud voice and dizzy laughter. That was a dizzy laughter. Dizzy is called something confused. Means everybody is having a type of confused and rippling. When you take round and round, then you started feeling some reeling. So that was the feeling was there, and everybody was laughing. Means everybody was enjoying on that roundabout ride. The child watched them intently and then he made a bold request. Intently is called very carefully. Okay, so child saw that roundabout and very carefully, with very intention, with his own intention, he requested. Bold requested means in a loud voice. Now this time his request was very loud. I want to go on the roundabout, please father and mother. Now he is requesting to his father, mother, that he now this time definitely want to sit on that roundabout. There was no reply. He turned to look at his parents. Nobody gave reply when he placed this request to go on the round, merry-go-round. Then he turned back. Why anybody is not giving him any answer? They were not there ahead of him. Means he was not finding his parents. His parents were not there. He turned to look on either side. They were not there. Now on the other side he looked and tried to see his parents, but they were not their side also. He looked behind, there was no sign of them. Now he looked behind of him, but no parents was There, a full deep cry rose within his dry throat, and within a sudden jerk of his body, he ran from where he stood. Now he started crying a lot. A deep cry started coming out. Rose is called coming out from his dry throat. Okay, throat means his throat became very much dry because of fear, because he was not able to find his parents. And there was a sudden jerk. Jerk is called movement. Means his body started moved suddenly, and he ran away from that place. Crying in a real fear, mother, father. Now he was crying, he was having a very much real fear, and he was crying a lot and calling his father and mother. Tears rolled down from his eyes, hot and fierce. His flushed face was convulsed with fear. Now tears started coming out from his eyes. He was very sad and crying too much. And then fierce is called hot and fierce, means he was also very angry, also very sad, in a very fearful manner. And flushed face means his face was all flushed with the tears. And convulsed is called trembled with the fear. He was shivering with the fear, a kind of fear. Which fear was there? Because he is left alone in that fear. He was not able to find his parents. Panic striken, he ran to one side first, then to other. Now, panic striken is called because of that sadness, because of that fear. He was running here and there in the fair, hither and thither in all the direction. Hither and thither is called here and there. From one direction to another direction, he was running all over where, knowing not where to go. He was not aware where he has to go. He was just running here and there to find out his father and mother. Mother, father, he wailed. Now, wailed is crying a lot. Okay, so he was crying a lot, calling his father and mother. His yellow turban came untied and his cloth became muddy. Now, he was wearing a turban on his head that became untied, means that opened out because he was running very hard from here and there. So, his turban opened out and his cloths all become muddy, spoiled or dirty. The people were having running to and fro in a rage of running for a while, he stood defeated. Now, to and fro means here and there, means after running too much in all the direction, now he stood defeated. Means he was not successful, he was not able to find out his parents. He was in a rage. Rage is called in a anger on himself. His cry suppressed into sobs. Now he was crying a lot, but after some time he started crying in pauses. Suppressed is called stopped or pressed. Sobs is called when you are crying after pauses, means you cry, then again stop, then again cry, then again stop. So his continuous cry turned in sobs. At little distance on the green grass, he could see through the filmy eyes man and woman were talking. So a little distance he could see through his filmy eyes. Filmy eyes means the eyes filled with the tears. When you see any emotional scene in the movie, then your eyes filled with the tears. So same tears filled with the eyes of that boy. He started looking at many women and men who were talking there at some distance. He tried to look intently among the patches of the bright yellow cloths. Now his parents must be wearing the yellow color cloth. So he started searching his parents among those people. But there was no sign of his father and mother among these people who seemed to laugh and talk just for the sake of laughing and talking. So he was busy in searching his parents wearing the yellow color patches of the cloth, that but he was not able to find his parents, where all the men and women, they all were busy in their laugh and talks. He ran quickly again, this time to a shrine to which people seemed to be crowding. Now this time he ran to a shrine. Shrine is a holy place or a temple, you can say, where too much crowd was there. Every little inch of space here was congested with man, but he ran through the people's lag. But there was too much crowd that not a inch of space was there so that he can go or find his way easily. But still, he was going through the legs of the people to find out his parents. and his little soap lingering. Now, lingering is called without any energy. Means he was still crying within in his low voice, without energy, and still he was calling mother, father. Near the entrance to the temple, however, the crowd became very thick. But where the entrance of the temple was there, there was that area was too much crowded. Many people were there. Men jostle each other. Jostle is called means everybody trying to find the way and to go inside the temple. Heavy man with flashing murderous eyes and hefty shoulder. Now every person who were there in the temple, near the temple, that was looking means they were very big, very broad, flashy means stouty, very fatty peoples were there with the murderous eyes, means the cruel, the red eyes was there, and hefty shoulder. Hefty is called large and heavy, means so many big and fatty peoples with the cruel eyes were there, and with their large and heavy shoulders. The poor child struggled to thirst away between the feet. Now thirst is called push, means that little poor child was struggling, was having a very a type of difficulty to find its way to pushing the people and going in between of their feet. Knocked to and fro by their brutal movements. Knocked is called means hit, means everybody was hitting here and there. Brutal is called cruel, means everybody was pushing each other in a cruel manner, and that brutal hit was also suffered by that little child. He might have been trampled underfoot. Trampled is called crushed, means that child could be trampled, could be crushed under a foot because there was so tall and heavy person were there. Had he not shrieked at the highest pitch of his voice, father and mother. Now means there was a moment when he find himself that he is about to crushed under the foot of any people. So he cried, he make a very loud voice and started to scream in his highest pitch of voice, highest volume of his voice, father, mother. A man in the surging crowd heard his cry and stooping with great difficulty lifted him up in his arm. Now there was a man who searched the crowd, means after finding the way from the crowd, he heard this cry, means he was crying so loud that he heard his cry, and stooping is called bent with difficulty, means the child was little, so that man bent himself downwards with the difficulty and lift that child in his arm. How did you get here, child? Whose baby are you? The man asked as he steered clear of the mass. Now steered clear means he can see clearly out of the mass. Mass is called crowd. Now the man is out of the crowd, taking the baby in his arm, and he was asking that how you come here? Where are your parents? The child wept more bitterly than ever now and only cried, I want my mother, I want my father. Now the child started crying a lot, bitterly is called more. The child started crying more, and only the thing he was saying that he wants to go to his parents. The men tried to soothe him by taking him to roundabout. Soothe him is called to make him relax, to make him comfortable. So that man took that child to a roundabout, to merry-go-round. Will you have a ride on the horse? He gently asked as he approached the ring. So as he approached the ride, he asked that boy that you want to sit in this ride? Would you like to sit in this ride? The child's throat tore into the thousand shrill sobs and he only shouted, I want my mother, I want my father. But the child's throat tore is called means to pieces, in the pieces, means that sob shrills is called the cry, the loud cry. The loud cry was again divided into pieces, means he started crying a lot in sobs, means in the pauses, and again he was stopping and crying, and he just was shouting in a loud voice that he just want his parents only. See in this picture how the kind man is trying to quieten the child by persuading him to buy the thing of his choice, but the child wants only his father and mother. The man headed towards the place where the snake charmer still played on the flute to the swaying cobra. Now the man took that child towards the snake charmer where still he was busy in playing the flute, and the cobra was coming and swaying is called moving on its music. Listen to that nice music, child, he pleaded. Now he requested to the child to listen to that pleasant music. But the child shut his ears with his fingers and shouted his doubled pitch strain. I want my mother, I want my father. But the child closed his ear with the fingers and again started shouted in double pitch strain, means more and more loud voice, that he just want his mother and father. The man took him near the balloons, thinking the bright colors of the balloons would distract the child's attention and quieten him. Now the man was very confused. Now he took that child to the balloon man, and he was thinking that after seeing these colorful, beautiful balloons, the child is going to distract his mind, means the child will be able to forget about the crying, and it may be quietened him, means it may be make him peaceful. Would you like a rainbow colored balloon? He persuasively asked. Persuasively, when you are making anyone ready to do something, okay? So the man was requesting that child that would you like to have different colors balloon? The child turned his eyes from the flying balloons and just sobbed, I want my mother, I want my father. But the child was not even ready to look at those balloons, and he just saying only this thing, that he wants his father and mother. The man is still trying to make the child happy, bore him to the gate where the flower seller sat. But the man was not giving up. He was carrying the child. Bore is called to carry the child. To carry the child at different places and try to make him happy anyway, in any manner. So this time now he reached to flower seller. Said, look, can you smell those nice flowers, child? Would you like a garland to put around your neck? Now again man requested to their child, see, these flowers are so beautiful, the smell of these flowers is so good, would you like to have one garland of this flower and you want to put around your neck, child? The child turned his nose away from the basket and reiterated his sob, I want my mother, I want my father. But the child was not looking there. He just turned his nose away. He doesn't want to smell to those beautiful flowers, and he reiterated, is called repeated. So he was repeated again his cries, and he was just saying that he wants to go to his parents. Thinking to humor his disconsolate charge by a gift of the sweets, the man took him to the counter of the sweet shop. Now the last time the man went to the last shop was the corner shop was the sweet shop. So humor is called when you say to make somebody happy, okay? And disconsolate is called very unhappy, means very difficult to try to make anyone happy, okay? Make someone to feel comfortable. So now thinking to humor means now he was thinking that something happy things should be done to make comfortable, and charge is called, charge has come for that man who was taking the possession, who was taking care of that child. So he was in charge for the happiness of that child. So he wants to give him the gift of sweets, means this is the last trial of that man, that maybe after getting sweets the child is going to be happy. So he took the child on the sweet shop counter. What sweets would you like, child, he asked. Now he was asking the child that which type of sweets he wants. The child turned his face from the sweet shop and only sobbed, I want my mother, I want my father. But child is still not was even ready for having any type of sweets. He was not even looking on the sweets, and he was just crying and sobbing and saying, I want my father and mother. And now we have come to the finish of this story. So you can see all the things the child have a strong desire for, means the balloons, the sweet shop, the snake, the garland, the flowers, all the things when he wanted, then he was not allowed. But now, when all the things are ready to have and ready to use, but now the child is not ready. So this is the sweet little story written by Mulk Raj Anand. I hope you understood the explanation. So that's it for now. We'll meet again.